Who gives this bride away in marriage? Stay standing while and bow your heads while we pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege of being in the body of Christ. We are gathered here today to join together this man and this woman in the covenant of marriage. We are gathered here today to watch the miracle of your love and the power of your Spirit work in their lives. We give to you the honor and the glory and the praise for the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives, and to bring us into a place of union with the Father, union with the Son, and union with the Holy Spirit, and union with another. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
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 Hello.
Hey, babe.
Hello. Can you see it?
I went through.
Yeah.
Oh, please be seated. Thanks, honey.
You're what?
Okay, I fixed my hair. Thanks.
The joining together of a man and a woman into marriage is one of the most sacred of Christian traditions. The covenant of marriage is symbolic of the covenant we have with Jesus Christ. When a couple prepares to enter their marriage covenant, it's extremely important that all parties understand exactly what is about to happen. It's not just between the man and the woman. The purpose of the wedding party, the best man, the maid of honor, the groomsmen, the bridesmaids, are to ratify and stand in agreement of this marriage. Even the families that are gathered together here are to act as witnesses to this new union. The covenant of marriage is the joining together of two distinct people as representatives of two distinct families, making one new family in the eyes of God. Starting a new bloodline that can grow generations of believers in Christ, populating the earth, then rejoicing in eternity with God. This is God's purpose for marriage. Today we're going to witness more than a ceremony, but a covenant made between Nathan and Hillary in the eyes of God, witnessed by you. Nathan and Hillary, you are about to make pledges before God and all these witnesses, pledging your lives to one another till death do you part. As you publicly profess your marriage vows in faith, the power of God then goes into operation. During this ceremony, a miracle takes place, as you'll be united by God and become one in His sight. As God is triune, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, so is the process of your joining together, spiritually by God, legally by contract, and physically by consummation. It's a miraculous union, a miracle from God, and it's taking place right here and now. The world has an idea that marriage is simply a legal contract, but it's so much more. At the same time, you're entering into a legal contract, you're entering into a spiritual contract. The Bible says where two or more are gathered in His name, He will be there in their midst, and there's no greater reason for the presence of God than when He is creating the spiritual bond that you two will have all the days of your life. The Bible commands wives to submit to their husbands. What gets lost in translation in this passage, I figured someone else would like to do that, not you. What gets lost in the translation of this passage is the word submit. It doesn't mean to be ruled over or take a back seat to the husband. It means to stand by his side. It means to have his back. Hillary, you will be Nathan's equal, standing by his side in good times and bad, enjoying your prosperity and working on your challenges together, hand in hand. Hillary, will you stand by Nathan's side and have his back while navigating life as his equal partner?
Are you actually asking me right now?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that requires an answer. The Bible also commands the husband, it's your turn. The Bible also commands the husband to love his wife as Jesus loved the church. We all know how much Jesus loved the church as He hung on the cross and died so we didn't have to. Nathan, the Bible also says that you should love your wife as your own body, as no man has ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes it and cherishes it. Nathan, dying for Hillary doesn't mean you would step in front of a bullet, which I assume you would do. It also means to die to yourself. Anything in your lifestyle that would put Hillary second. Are you prepared to make sure Hillary's needs are taken care of before your own?
I am.
Happy wife, happy life. Starts with putting your wife first, above anything else in your family, which will include your children when that time comes. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and his mother. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall be joined unto his wife, and the two of them shall become one flesh. I've often heard people that have been married a long time say their secret to successful marriage is compromise and understanding and patience and forgiveness. And I say if this is their key to success, they may need marriage counseling. I say the secret to success, a successful marriage, is passion, excitement, fun, humor, and adventure. Nathan, you are marrying the love of your life. You propose because of your passion for Hillary. Don't ever let that diminish. Hillary, you said yes because of your passion for Nathan. Do whatever it takes to stay passionate. If you two ever get to the point where compromising and forgiving are happening more than being passionate, take a step back and reorganize your thoughts. And remember, you chose to spend the rest of your lives together. And it wasn't just to survive, it was to experience fireworks. And often. Nathan, you served your country, and we all thank you for that. You've operated under many stressful circumstances, and you passed all your tests. You've accomplished amazing things, from being in the top of your class in the Air Force Academy, understanding mechanics like a master tech, and now you build rockets for Elon Musk. Hey. But there's something else more honorable than serving your country and succeeding in the workplace, and that's serving your wife and giving her every reason to remain passionate. To give honor to your role that you'll have as the husband, the provider, and someday the father. So, and don't think your tests are a thing of the past either. You just need to pray a little differently. Hillary, you have passed many stressful tests too. You were the number one seeded varsity tennis player at La Costa Canyon High School when you were 13 years old. You knew tennis was going to get in this, didn't you?
Yeah. Right.
You got an athletic scholarship to play NCAA tennis at Point Loma Nazarene University. You became a tennis pro, and you taught kids of the stars like Adam Levine. And then you entered the job market, and you landed amazing positions. You, too, have passed many tests. Now your focus will be to give Nathan every reason to stay passionate, to honor your role as the wife and someday the mother. Before I ask Nathan and Hillary to say their vows, I want to speak to the best man, maid of honor, groomsmen, and bridesmaids. About this covenant and about what is to take place. You're not simply here out of tradition. You have a far more important purpose than that. You are here to be witnesses forever of this miracle of Nathan and Hillary becoming one in marriage. You are here to add your agreement before God with them to that which is about to take place. Don't ever tamper with this agreement. Don't ever allow anyone else to tamper with it. Regardless of what happens, you must always be in agreement of this union. If you're in agreement, say, I will.
I will.
Now I want to speak to the families and everyone sitting here in attendance. In the eyes of God, Nathan and Hillary are washed in the blood of the Lamb, born again Christian believers. They have prayed and agreed together to come here before you to be joined together as husband and wife. They believe with all their hearts this is the perfect will of God for them forever. So from now on until the end of time, please do everything in your power to see that this union remains strong, happy, and prosperous. See to it that you do all you can when you're present with Nathan and Hillary not to distract from their roles, putting each other first. If you are in agreement, say, we will.
We will.
Thank y'all.
You have the rings? You remembered them?
James?
They're sweaty.
Nor mine, it's okay. Here. He's shaking.
Give him to me.
You're good.
Okay.
Nathan,
we're good.
Take Hillary's hand. Well, you already have. Nathan, do you take this woman to be your wife as your own flesh, to love her even as Christ loves the church, to protect her, to care for her, to honor her in sickness and in health, forsaking all of others so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Then make this pronouncement. I, Nathan Jacoby, according to the will of God,
I, Nathan Jacoby, according to the will of God,
shall leave my father and my mother and join myself to you to be your husband.
Shall leave my father and mother and join myself to you as your husband.
From this moment forward, we shall be one.
From this moment forward, we shall be one.
For better and for worse, for richer or poorer.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and honor and to cherish you till death do us part.
To love and honor and cherish you till death do us part.
According to God's holy word, I give you my life.
According to God's holy word, I give you my life.
Which one's hers?
That one. That one.
Place this ring on her finger.
Yeah.
You put it on the wrong. No, you didn't.
Got it.
I have to speak now.
Hillary?
Yes.
It's your turn.
Okay.
Hillary Ramage. I didn't say Nathan Jacoby. I said Hillary Ramage. I just wanted to hear it one more time.
Last time.
Hey, don't rub it in. Do you take this man to be your husband?
I do.
So, not yet done. All right, kiss and see you later. Submitting yourself to him as unto the Lord, showing reverence to him as head of the union, to love him, to honor him, and to keep him, forsaking all others so long as you live.
I do.
Okay.
I do.
Vince. I say, repeat after me, I, Hillary Ramage, according to the will of God.
I, Hillary Ramage, according to the will of God.
Join myself to you, submitting myself only to you to be your wife.
Oh, that's a rough one. Join myself to you, submitting myself only to you to be your wife.
You got it. Right. From this moment forward, we shall be one.
From this moment forward, we shall be one.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and health.
To love and cherish, to death do us part.
Love and cherish, to death do us part.
According to God's holy word, I give you my life.
According to God's holy word, I give you.
Get this ring.
That one.
No,
this one.
Nathan and Hillary, you may. Nathan, you may kiss your bride.
Come on, over here. We did it.
Oh, yeah!
I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Nathan Jacoby.
Are you going to kiss me?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, baby. Ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah. Come here. Don't break my dress this time.